Tor and Odin were in the photo with the clicker. They might know how it works. I'm off the case, but I can still visit family.
Hello?
Saga! It's Tor, your grandfather. About time you were coming to visit, kiddo.
How did you know I was coming to see you?
Never mind that. We have bigger problems. We're losing. Oh, fuck! Fuck you, you fucking hag! Fuck!
Shit. Something is off at that nursing home. Another one of those cult boxes. There's a rhyme over here. Keep trying. Doesn't make sense. Another charm. Good thing Logan made me this bracelet. Good job, Saga. Now keep moving. Another Alex Casey lunchbox? Monsters. Tor and Odin claim to be my family. I know Logan and I never lived here. But I don't know enough about my family history to say they're not my relatives. Mom only ever said my grandfather was bad news. The less I knew about him, the better.
Saga? What's up? Hello, Rose. Thought I'd swing by, see the family. Not a bad time, is it?
Oh, no. I was just, you know, tidying the... I'm so glad you're visiting again, Saga. But Odin and Tor can't see anyone today.
I was just on the phone with Tor. He invited me over.
Sorry. They had a little too much fun on our trip to Watery and need to rest.
I need an excuse to get in and talk to them. That's too bad. Okay if I say hi to the other residents before I go?
Sure. They always love visitors. Come on in. Not smart to be outside when the sun goes down.
I love the architecture. I always dreamed of living in a haunted Victorian manor.
You say that like it's your first time here.
Here's some of our residents, or, as I like to call them, our little Vikings. Look who swung by, everyone! Norman! Clothes! Norman, we have a visitor! Where are your clothes?
I'm headed back to the sauna with Ati.
Just another day in Valhalla. I should really get back to work, Saga. But feel free to spend some time with Mandy May and Norman here. It's good for them to have company.
Tor and Odin are here somewhere. Need to find them.
Ati, this is your home. You don't need to keep cleaning. I take that mop away, but I know you'll just find it again.
Girl, girl, what a once after being told no. Why rest when you are born to work?
And you... Why don't you go pick a song from the jukebox?
Yes, box only rain. Just thinking about it makes my dad's food wagon.
I feel bad for these guys. Need to find the key.
The government built a bunker here during World War II.
I shouldn't interrupt him.
To watch the ocean for Axis navies and who knows what else. Ever since they sealed the bunker, it's been a hot spot for teens. The Ocean View Motel and Spa, they call it, ironically, I believe. They go there to enjoy their beer and their vapes and all that fun cigarettes.
This is Tor's room. More moonshine. Was this a drunken rampage? This place is a mess. And Tor's not here. I need to keep looking.
Excuse me, miss, But you don't see me barging into your room while you're performing mental and physical strengthening exercises, do you? I thought not.
Sorry. Don't mind me.
And now I have to start over.
Odin's in bad shape. He was drunk and watery. Or is this something more serious? That woman in the painting looks like Mom. Was I born here? Or is this more of the story? Can you hear me, Odin? Odin Addison, can you hear me? I need to ask you a couple of questions. Odin? He's in no shape to talk. Odin's in rough shape.
These are our twilight years. There's darkness in the water. We have our little tricks, and so do you.
What's happening? It's never felt this way before.
You're all grown up, Saga, dearest. And you're back just in time. The forces of darkness are eating away at us. We're too old and weak. You have the power in you, like all Andersons.
What was that? He wasn't a projection. Odin was really here. We were connected. Are they really my family? Is that why this is happening? I found a photograph of you with the cultists. How are you involved?
We're too old for this brand of crazy, but we'll drink with anyone who's offering. The cult's been on our asses to join for years, but we already have our band, and those damn fools don't know what they're dealing with. No wonder they want a pair of legends.
Tor and Odin are not part of the cult. The cult thinks there's something special about Tor and Odin. I'm starting to see it, too. I've never connected to someone like this in my mind place before. How is this happening?
I was glad to answer your call. Vikings are born travelers. You are a seer. You can see the truth. But your grandpa will want to tell you more himself. Wouldn't want to steal his thunder. Tor is in danger. You can save him.
Is my mind place more than just a mental technique? Sometimes my mind place even baffles me. Is this the reason? Is there something more than intuition behind it? One thing at a time. Tor is in trouble. Once I help him, he can maybe tell me more. You said Tor is in danger. What's going on?
Darkness is drawn to the spark. Tor only thinks with his hammer, never his head. The Prince of fucking Darkness is making a comeback. Tor's marked by darkness. I can feel it. Is he in his room? It wants to take him, and then take me. Beware of Cynthia Weaver. Bad things happen in the Wellness Center. Don't let her drag him under, Saga.
Does Prince of Darkness refer to Scratch? Is Tor becoming taken? I need to find him before it's too late. Stop this before more people get hurt. I found Wake's clicker. What can you tell me about it?
Cut off from Tom's lamp. It washed to the shore. Good work getting the light switch. The light switch is like an amp. You can play rock and roll without it, but you won't blow anyone away. Art, like Tom's writing, can change the world, but the light switch will crank that change to 11.
The clicker has the power to change the story. To save Logan. This confirms what Wake said. I can't let Scratch get his hands on the clicker. By Tom's writing, Odin must mean Wake. Tor and Odin might know something about the clicker. With Wake out of reach, this is my best lead. Nah. Think, Saga. Tor is not okay. Something is definitely going on here. The clicker makes Wake's writing change reality. Can I trust him with that much power? Not sure I have a choice. Doesn't make sense. That's not right.
Getting in is forbidden for your own safety. Time is long for those who wait. But in the end, stand the tanks.
Sheesh, didn't see you there. I don't have the key.
Always dream to see in New York in a fancy hotel. This will put a smile back on your face, my dear.
Sorry? She's one of them. There must be an overlap here somewhere. You said I'd been here before. When was the last time I visited? Let's see exactly what she thinks she remembers.
Oh, it's been years. We were all so sad when you left. After the accident.
Oh, fuck this. My daughter didn't drown. You're remembering wrong. She's at home watching Night Springs with her father.
Mm-hmm.
It's useless. I need to stop the story. Tor's in the wellness center, isn't he?
No, he's... Well, yes, but you really shouldn't go in there right now.
I'm gonna need you to unlock the door. This is FBI business.
But it's just... There's some things that, Yes, okay, I'll let you in.
Thank you, Rose.
Watch out. For puddles. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
Right. Thanks. That lady is a walking red flag. Be ready, Saga. Hello? Tor? It's Saga Anderson. Thank you. He's hurt pretty bad. But he tore off his bandages. Why? Tor was here. Odin said Tor needs help. But from what? Is he turning into a Taken? Tor is being targeted. He needs help.
Saga had slid into a nightmare. A growing amount of evidence said her daughter was dead. Saga couldn't accept that. Wake said it could be undone. But Wake was gone, in the custody of the Federal Bureau of Control. Casey, her only ally, was gone too. She was alone. Agent Estevez had pulled rank on her, stonewalled her, shut her out of her own case. Saga refused to give up. She needed answers. Tor and Odin Anderson would have some. A family visit, then. No one could blame her for that. Saga was trapped in a horror story. It was manifesting itself around her like the darkness of a mental illness, pushing her deeper and deeper.
Be opened on this side. Tor, wait! It's me! Come on. An electric lock. Looks like it's controlled remotely. door needs a knob. A security computer. Needs a password. And a warrant, technically. But hey, desperate times. The Koskala brothers aren't just in the cult. They're its damn leaders. Day, then month. He uses European formatting.
The cult's been on our asses to join for years. But we already have our band. And those damn fools don't know what they're dealing with. No wonder they want a pair of legends.
No.
Sorry, we're at a Bright Falls blend. Anna apologized to the customers. I'll just grab some from the back. More coffee coming right up. She suggested they ride the percolator while they waited. She passed Ilmo at the Espresso Express. Big smile, Anna. Coffee world is all smiles. Anna nodded, smiled. She smiled until her face hurt. Anna stopped walking, realized she was standing... Tor Anderson had lightning in his veins. This was rock and roll, baby. That Weaver girl had cast a spell on him. Tor would do anything she'd ask. Tor deserved this. Tor wanted this. She wanted the song. A gift. He had to get it for her. Afterwards, it was too late. Tor swung his hammer in frustration. The spark was gone. Black liquid clogged his mind. A bad trip. Tor fought it. He was strong. He'd never be taken. But the darkness could still drown him. Tor needed to warn someone. It was all happening again. Tom was back. Coming back. Tom would need help too if he was going to make it. But the brothers were too old to stop at this time. Tor had called someone. Someone who could help. The name escaped him. Drowned beneath dark water.
Tor left the wellness center. Nope. I have what I need to figure out the password. The computer controls the door that Tor went through. And the doors are open.
Shit!
Need to catch up with Tor. What was that? Where did Tor go?
What on earth do you mean, Sokka? Tor is resting in the wellness center. Remember?
What? We both saw him go into the pond.
Okay.
Are you fucking with me? Or is this the story again?
Now. Let's cool it with the language.
She's clearly lying to me. Why? Rose watched Tor go into the pond. Why is she lying to me?
The secret mission for Alan's number one fan. The hero will say Wake has returned. We're all characters in his story. Gee whiz.
I'm not his fucking character. But I can use that phrase to make Rose stop lying to me. Wake has returned. Cynthia took Tor. What happened to her?
When the darkness touches your head, your bookshelf gets shuffled. I put her lamp in the shoebox. What do you call a lamp lady without her lamp?
Is Rose talking about Cynthia or herself? Or both? Rose. Wake has returned.
Oh my God. You're the hero! You're here to save Alan! I feel so silly for trying to keep you out of the wellness center. I locked Tor and Gale in there after they lost it, and I didn't want you getting hurt. Before I forget, here's the page Wake told me to give you. Oh, and you'll need my keys to get around.
Saga jabbed the selector on the jukebox, the missing record in its place. Saga couldn't have found it without Odin's help. A light bloomed in through the garden window.
The horror story beat me to Tor. I have to rescue him. The key to this overlap is an old Gods of Asgard record. Odin will know more. Those kids' lunch boxes.
Perfect morning for me to drink this coffee I'm holding. Oh shit, this coffee is shit. Yako, did you just drink regular brand coffee? Oh, I did. My perfect morning is ruined. And all because of your shit coffee. If only we could have good coffee. Hey,
what?
What's that sound? Gilmore, look, it's the Bright Falls blended organic coffee from All Deer Diner.
Oh, wow. I've heard that the health benefits of this coffee include increased energy, improved eyesight, better lovemaking, and deeper connection to animals. With a thermos full of hot coffee, you are always prepared for what comes. How does it taste, young man? Bright Falls blend organic coffee is brewed with care right here in the Pacific Northwest from coffee beans that are sourced locally, Puerto Rico. Try it today at Coffee World and the Old Deer Diner, and don't forget to try the delicious brunch special this month only for Deer Fest.
Tor disappeared into the pond. It's another overlap. Has to be. How do I get inside?
Odin Anderson stirred in his bed, his vision hazy, smudged. He felt weighted down by an ocean of dark water. Through the haze, he made out Saga. Odin felt useless. He wished he could tell Saga how his silly faces made her smile when she was young. Too young to remember. Odin used to joke that Tor was her grandfather, but he was the Allfather. He smiled at the memory. Odin was the kinder of the Anderson brothers. Tor lacked patience, more volatile. The brothers fought a lot, but they were inseparable. Now Tor was missing, dragged into darkness. Odin could feel it. Time was running out for both of them. Saga jabbed the selector on the jukebox. The missing record in its place. Saga couldn't have found it without Odin's help. Standing there, Saga felt exposed, expecting the shadows to come alive. The needle crackled on the vinyl. The song swelled. Odin had said it was written for her and her mother. Her grandfather's apology. The lamentation of an old man. His heart was broken, sinking into darkness. Odin had said that the song would be a way to know Tor, a way to find him. A light bloomed in through the garden window. That's where Tor had vanished into the pond. Saga knew what she had to do.
The page mentions a missing record. Do you know where it is, Odin?
Driven by passion, raging like a storm. Your grandfather made the song to apologize to your mother, Freya, and to you. Tor's like a storm. Your mother did the right thing, leaving with you, even if it broke your grandfather's heart. And mine. Listen to the song, Saga. It's all there. Tor only had one record made. He keeps it in the museum.
Odin knows my mom's name. He's saying my mom took me away when I was still a baby. Plausible. Stay on task. The record is in the museum. Hello there. Saga Anderson.
Hey, Basine. Name won't make the man worse. Even a Swedish name. I'm Martin.
Do you know anything about the cult of the tree?
Yes, yes. He who reaches for a spruce tree will stumble into a juniper. Bloom was one of them. He has kicked empty. I wouldn't want to be in his shoes. But I like his shoes.
How did you know Blum was part of the cult?
Oh, Fox never runs out of tricks. He's a crazy man, and he will show his ways. Blum liked to talk.
Key fob's no good without power.
No use crying in the dark place. What has been, has gone. But trouble doesn't look like this. You can go to the basement and check the generator. But look out. You can never know in which tree the devil sits.
The basement. Thanks. Think. The page says the record will open the overlap. Or is the page predetermining it? Am I just playing into the story? I can't open this with my bare hands. monsters. Key fob's no good without power.
Wheeler set up a foundation with the sales of their greatest hits album. He used the cash to build a nursing facility. The old men deserved it. An old manor in Bright Falls. Wheeler hired a contractor to have it refitted as an old folks' care home. At this point, Wheeler felt good about himself. He had a heart of gold. No need to feel guilty. Wheeler left the work to the contractor and returned to New York City. He had done his part. It was time to turn over a new leaf. The contractors figured out Wheeler was gone for good. They took the money and ran. When the fall rains came, the leaks started appearing.
Fuse is blown. Maybe there are spares nearby. Can't be opened on this side.
Emmett Elwood had had enough. All his life, he'd been surrounded by the same small-minded, impolite, ignorant people in town. Their endless gossip, their nose-picking, chewing food with their mouths open, not washing their hands after visiting the restroom, and touching things, touching everything. The world was going to hell. He'd watched day after day how all the nice things in life in Bright Falls were spoiled and ruined forever. There would be a just and terrible reckoning. Emmett had imagined many times how he'd make them pay. He had lovingly tended his anger, made it grow hotter. It was out in the open now. Ugly and slobbering, they reached at him with their unwashed hands. He beat them down, beat them until they no longer moved. And then he'd wash his hands with a strong antibacterial disinfectant.
The power's off.
Cynthia Weaver had always kept her lantern close. Someone in the bathroom with her. In the dark. Dark water pressed itself into her. She screamed.
Must be locked from the other side. There. Power's back on. Is this something they watch on movie night? That looks just like Casey. What the hell is going on?
Coming. Saga was trapped in the forest door.
Adam? Was Cynthia into civil engineering? The Dark Presence uses people's memories, their fears, to corrupt them. I feel like I'm missing some context here. A lantern. Was Cynthia using it for protection? Did she know about the Dark Presence? I'm guessing the woman in this photograph was not Cynthia's favorite. A power station. Everyone needs a hobby, I guess. Tor's a romantic, huh?
Cynthia would deal with the nasty Anderson fellow, Tor, always poking people with his hammer. He had it coming. Cynthia Weaver hated being old. She'd been a doer, a fighter. Now the bathroom frightened her, afraid she'd break her hip, like Norman. Cynthia had always kept her lantern close, to hold the darkness at bay. Oh dear, my lantern. I think I've lost it, Cynthia said. This will put a smile back on your face, my dear, a voice said. A man's voice. Someone in the bathroom with her, in the dark. The light bulb had blown. She meant to replace it days ago. How could she forget? She had slipped getting out of the tub. She lay in the tub now. She lifted her hand. It looked wrong. Too many hands. In a black void with no sense of up or down, she was underwater. A dark shape pushed her down. Dark water pressed itself into her. She screamed. It came out in bubbles. Cynthia Weaver smiled. Lost without her lantern? Nonsense. Cynthia felt as giddy as a young girl in love. Cynthia had loved Thomas Zane. Tom only had eyes for Barbara. Barbara was bad news. Tom had seen it in the end. Cynthia had been there to comfort him. And when he left, Cynthia waited. Years of waiting. Now Tom had come back to her. They'd be together now. See the world. She'd always dreamed of seeing New York. They were there now in a fancy hotel. She drew a bath. She would become like Barbara. No, better. She sank into dark water. Into Tom. Tom had enemies plotting against him. Cynthia would deal with the nasty Anderson fellow, Tor, always poking people with his hammer. He had it coming. Anything for Tom. Emmett Elwood had had enough. All his life, he'd been surrounded by the same small-minded, impolite, ignorant people in town. Their endless gossip, their nose-picking, chewing food with their mouths open.
Anga's remorse. This is the one. But it's gone. Cynthia has the record. She will tell me where to find it. Cynthia targeted Tor specifically. Why him?
Deal with the nasty Anderson fellow. His heart was broken. Cancelled. Leaks started appearing. It was too late. Shut her out of her own case.
The Dark Presence is using Cynthia to keep me from talking to Tor. Where is Angus Remorse now?
Giddy is a young girl in love. A broken brawl pleads it. The shadows to come alive. A gift. An on-off death wish.
She has the record. I can get it out of her. Cynthia was close to someone named Thomas Zane. Who is he?
Tom was back. Tom had enemies. In a fancy hotel. Just his imagination. A nightmare started to creep in. Cynthia Weaver smiled.
An old flame. Maybe Tom was taken. Anga's remorse. Where is it, Cynthia?
Drowned beneath dark water. Too many hands. The bathroom frightened her. Cut short. She screamed. An old folks' care home.
The Anga's remorse record is in Cynthia's room. In her bathtub. Anga's remorse is missing. Who took it?
Our shame becomes the pale horse. Oh, Tor, bro. Tor's love for you is in that song. That's why Cynthia wants it, to ruin him. She made Tor lust after her. We fought one scratching hag years ago. Now he's fallen for another, and we might lose him for good. One less Anderson.
That isn't going to happen. Cynthia has torn the overlap. Anga's remorse is the key to get there. I need to make Cynthia reveal its location. Anga's Remorse, by Old Gods of Asgard. I need to play it in the jukebox.
The dark water thrust itself into her.
The song will show me the way.
Look in the mirror, the cobweb of my soul. My face forever, seeking to be whole. Driven by passion, raging like a storm. With thunder and lightning and the hubris I was born. Blood, heart and pain, I risk to take it all. Blind to your pain, your wounds, my downfall. You can't.
A dead end. The wall just disappeared. The light did that?
Oh. closer. Destroy it. The only way.
It's a loop, like the others. I need to reach the center. Cynthia. She's here. Nearby. back again. Gotta go deeper. I need to get the lights on to reach him. You took Tor. I'm here to take him back.
Saga! So damn dark down here. I'm underwater! At the bottom. I don't think I'm gonna make it.
Where'd she go? I can't stand any further.
Was under water. Dark. You can apologize to him yourself. I'm getting you the hell out of here.